Adesso sì, posso la vedere.
One second, hold on.
Okay.
Okay. Listen up, please.
Lei può avere l'universo se io posso l'avere l'Italia. These are Giuseppe Verdi's Italian composer's words, which refer to Italy, and which mean, you may have the universe if I may have Italy. Knowing Italian culture is very important because its culture is very rich. History and traditions have flourished for centuries. We are credible because Italy is the culture we are interested in the most, and we have made a two-week research about this country in order to deliver you as credible and as interesting information as we can. Today, we are going to present you Italian culture and society. We're going to represent Italian culture through music, fashion, and Italian society.
Our first main point will be music, which represents Italian culture and its history very well. Italian folk music has a very deep and complex history which goes back to thousands of years ago. Does anyone know what is the connection between Italian mafia and folklore? Of course not. According to the BBC News, 2 years ago in Italy, a CD was released which called I Quanto di Malavita, which means the songs of life of Italian crime. And the reason why it's so important is that the CD is a sacred strand of Italian folk culture, and the lyrics make a contribution to Italian codes and values, which leads to violence, and the government always tries to make a ban such kind of CDs and lyrics as well as. Besides this really interesting information, I would like to talk about Italian opera. Italy is the birthplace of opera, founded many years ago and famous all over the world. Every year, Italy opera houses offer us seasons rich in various of performances. Italian opera houses always begins between November and December and represents a very important and interesting moment of their culture. According to the Italian Opera House's main webpage, the first formal name which was used in the 17th century was Opera di Musica, which means work in music. It is interesting who invented opera, of course Italian, and the world's famous Italian opera singers like Luciano Pavarotti, José Carreras, and Placido Domingo continues to cultivate the best of Italian opera as a part of their culture. Today, Italian opera is a part of their export to Italy, and Italian opera stimulates people to learn their really interesting and beautiful language and their history as well as. Now that we have talked about musical background, we would like to move on our next main point, which will refer to fashion, fashion weeks, and the world's famous fashion designers.
Elegance is in the Italian blood, and most Italians would unhesitatingly give up comfort in order to achieve it. As you have already guessed, our second point is fashion. Here we present you the names of legendary fashion designers who have already made a history of fashion. A legendary fashion designer, Giorgio Armani, was the first designer to ban models with a body mass index under 18. Dolce & Gabbana, one of the most famous fashion designers, whose annual turnover, according to Italian Legacy, exceeds £900 million, making them one of the most influential and most powerful Italian fashion designers in the world. Valentino, who is completely different from others. Maybe he is not so influencing like other influential designers, like Chanel or Dior, but he tries to make the clothes that women will wear. According to New York Times, the Versace myth is what makes the Versace name world famous. It is centered on the idea of a world of fashion, of beauty and glamour. There are other fashion designers like Ferré or Prada.
Also, Milan Fashion Weeks are part of Italian fashion, founded in 1958. Fashion weeks are held twice a year to showcase the spring, summer, and fall winter collections. Exhibited designers have included luxury Italian famous designers, as you said, like Dolce & Gabbana, Versace, Prada, Gucci, and so on. It is really interesting what is the fashion in this year, and according to the Italian Fashion Weeks magazine webpage, designers recommended us to wear clothes with black and white colors and also retro prints. Now that we have discussed about fashion, Fashion Weeks in Milan, and world famous fashion designer Seva, we would like to move on our next main point, which will be very interesting because it's the first Italian people and their communication styles.
We may not have it all together, but together we will have it all. This quote refers to a traditional family. So let's talk about Italian traditional families in general. Italian are referred to collectivistic societies. They are group-oriented people because of their strong emphasis on family relationships. In 70% of cases, there are three children in families, in Italian families. According to Accad de Pew, related relatives often gather together in order to enjoy homemade meal. Children live with their parents much longer than they do in other Western countries. And it is common for a child to live near their parents, but not apart. Sometimes they even stay and live in their parents' apartment with aunts, uncles, their children, other relatives together in a big, friendly Italian family.
Italian communication styles are worldly and emotional. According to the Business University's webpage, there are some important rules which we should consider. For example, hospitality is the main part of their culture. Never refuse an invitation to their dinner. Personal space is much smaller than Italy in America, and Italians are generally not refused by people cutting ahead from the line. Today we have informed you more about Italian culture, their rules, society, musical background, and fashion.
The points we have discussed today are music, fashion, and Italian society. Hopefully, we can refer to Verdi's romantic words, which bring us to Italy even closer. Lei può avere l'universo se io posso avere Italia, which means you may have the universe if I may have Italy. Thank you for your time.
I really liked your presentation, and I want to ask what's your favorite food. I know it's food, so I want to ask what's your favorite food, Italian food, maybe.
I really love pizza, about food, and that was the first time I ate pizza when I was firstly in Italy. Before that time, I didn't eat pizzas, I don't know why, but the first time I ate pizza was in Italy.
Also tiramisu. If you have your favorite speaker, and if you had it, and who is she or he?
Inspirational. And now that we are talking more about music, I know that she is an opera singer, and she is like an inspiration for me. She is a mezzo soprano singer, Cecilia Bartoli, and I really love to listen to her. This is my inspiration about music. And also Anna Netrebko, but she is not Italian, so now we are talking about it.
One last comment since we're running out of time. As you said, you were in Italy, and I have one question. Did you have this information before, or did you find it now?
Of course, we have gained some sources, but I knew about architecture because I have seen many architectural sites. And as we have already gone through in constructive engineering about architecture, I didn't really want to get to that topic again. So I have chosen some different topics for this speech. Yes.
I have a question. As you said, you were in Italy, and it is said that Georgians and Italians are similar. What do you think about?
I think they are quite similar as Spanish people and Italian people, with appearance also, because they are more darker than other European countries, and also with attitude. They are more outgoing, sociable, and their families are also quite common to ours.
All right, I think we're
going
to have to call it a day since we're running short on time. So, Rand, nice job.
Before we start, we would like to ask a volunteer from the audience.
Is somebody going to record that?